shall we? Okay. I'm glad you came to see me. Yes, I am a private doctor. I only brought an emergency preparedness first aid kit with me. So if you need further medical attention, then I will have to refer you out and get an ambulance here. You sure you don't need it? Okay, I'll do the best I can. Explain to me what happened while I unbox this. Sanitizer and aspirin. Okay, so first off, take the aspirin, and I mean take both. Okay, that'll relieve some of the pain. There you go. I'm going to disinfect my hands first. From the outside world, I wash them, but I want to make sure, you know, I touch the doorknob, I touch the handle of my car, everything. Stuff smells pretty good. Oh no, this is free of charge, honey, don't worry. Alright, so I recommend you use this hand sanitizer pouch, okay? And it will make sure that everything you came into contact doesn't infect you. So if you had like a scratch here and you itch that scratch, use this. There you go. Good. What time is it? It's time for you to get a watch. No, I'm kidding. Just some doctor humor there. It is currently 10 o'clock. Okay, so before I use any of this stuff, I want to make sure I know what I'm doing. Okay, so I'm going to have to unbox everything in this kit. My belongings. At least you hand sanitized and got the aspirin, so you're safe for now. sure how this is a blanket. This is actually good for when it is sunlight outside. So Pancho, you don't need that, so let's use the blanket. Seeing any potential problem. What is this?
the gates of hell.
Okay, I think that's enough. All right, no more radio. All right, so. These are to treat small cuts and burns. These are very interesting and strangely shaped bandages. Ah, Q-tips, perfect. We're gonna need those. Against your skin for as long as possible on your wrist, because I know you said you fell on your wrist, so there's bruising there. Well, we don't need to use the CPR breathing barrier, thank goodness. This against your dry forehead to see if you have a fever, and it'll change to the color listed here to see what temperature you have. Let's give it a shot. Exercising within at least 30 minutes, or if you just came out from the outdoors. No, okay. All right, let's see what you have. It is 98.6, I believe, so that seems pretty normal. So here's some scissors. We don't need that. I got an extra pair. Some pins. Useful to hold up some of your clothing. Oh, and it comes with a guide. Great, that comes last. I don't need it anymore. Tweezers. We need to pull out some of those thorns. And one of these. So let's check your tongue. fever, but that's the least of my worries now. Hold out your tongue. Okay. I'm not seeing anything that could worry me. Okay. First and then the big boss. So we're gonna bandage the little cuts and scrapes, and then we're gonna take care of the big wound, which is still oozing, as I see, but not nicely. bandages. Just our luck. It just started to rain, so you might want to wear this. Alright. Perfect. You don't want water getting in your wounds and stuff, so we just want to make sure and protect you. Alright, I'll drive you in my car and we'll be on our way to the hospital. You're going to be just fine. It's already stopped. That's a good sign. They just need to check you, evaluate for you for infection, make sure you're okay. I can only do so much and bandage you up so much, but it's all up to you to take care of yourself. Afterward, they'll prescribe you something to stop possible infection, and they will unwrap your bandages and triangle wrap as necessary themselves, okay? Especially the eyes, they'll go ahead and check. light stick. Anyway, see you.